Vitaly Milonov, first of all, how would you expect Russia is likely to respond to this?
Strange, how can we respond towards some fake news? Nothing to deal with Russian reality. We don't have any agents that are not under control of the special services.
You'd rule out that there was loss of control.
Any crime should have a motivation.
If they are able to prove that this came from a Russian laboratory, from what you are saying, then it must have been authorized by the regime because they don't lose control.
This poison is 50 years old. It's not a modern stuff. You can take this poison from any laboratory in Ukraine or other fake countries that are happy to help you. So I think this is something to deal with theater or James Bond movie.
I don't think a British Prime Minister would say what she said in the House of Commons without having
strong
evidence.
She will need to go public with it, won't she? What is the motivation?
In his election campaign, President Putin has been portraying himself as a strong man, saying that he ordered a civilian airliner to be shot down. He's boasting about his new nuclear weapons capacity to hit the United States. And this attempted assassination has also, remember, been welcomed by Russian state media. So they have a problem whether to boast about it or to deny it.
It's not a deal of any Polish prostitute to make comments on Russian elections. We don't need any comments from Poland or other small countries dependent from the United States about our own elections. Theresa May and her colleagues, they have created a fake story. They had to kill or to try to kill this poor pensioner, useless for us. It's a behavior of Hitler, when he blamed someone.
So the UK government is behaving like Hitler. So I want to come back to Radek Sikorski there. Please feel free to respond to what you heard from Mr. Milonov.
I think he gave best witness to his own character. This attack is so brazen. Whoever did it must have known that the British authorities would find out what substance was used and how it could be traced. I think it's actually an opportunity for Prime Minister May to show her mettle. But the question is, what would work? And I think President Putin is wagering that Britain is so hooked on Russian money in London that the response will be muted, just like it was after the Litvinenko murder.